We are glad that you liked our earlier videos. Please don't forget to share it and subscribe it, and also don't forget to comment. Your comments are most important for us. So one of the people, not one, actually many of my patients as well as the people have been talking about plank. Ma'am, what is plank? So I thought, why not give the whole workout of plank, which you can make a workout in your daily life. And if you can't do plank, we have a different workout for you. We'll talk about it later. Let's start. Today Geeta Shenoy will be helping us showing all the plank variation. There are more than 25 variations of plank, but the main plank position is six of them. Let us start with shoulder plank or high plank, which we say. You can always start with a shoulder plank. Shoulder apart, legs slightly shoulder length apart. Your buttock should not be up. So if you do this, this is wrong. Your buttock should be slightly down, and you hold this position for as much time as possible. So plank is a whole body workout and it is an isometric workout. Now you initially, if you can do it for 10 seconds, do it for 10, 20, 30. Repeat it as many times as possible. That's how you will build up your stamina. So if you can do today 30 seconds, try to do it 40 seconds tomorrow and do 2 or 3 repetitions, and slowly, slowly you can make it to a minute. Okay? Second one is the most famous position, that is elbow plank. They say that when the plank fad started, it was only about elbow plank. Legs slightly, shoulder length apart, hips down, straight, and hold this pose for as much time as possible. Again, you can start with 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, do 2 or 3 times and build up your stamina over a period of time. Our next plank is low plank. So you come to elbow plank and you take your body almost parallel to the ground but not touching the ground. So your knee is above, your chest is above. You hold it there as much time as possible and relax. So again, depends on you, 10 seconds, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, start with this workout and repeat it as many times as possible and build up your time over a period of time. Next plank is side plank. Your shoulder and elbow are on one line. Your both legs are together. You give pressure from your elbow and you take your hip up. Hold it as much time as possible. If you just cannot do it at all, you can actually separate the leg. Can you separate it? Yes. So you can keep your leg like that. If you cannot do it, preferably the other way around. Again, hold it for as much time as possible and repeat it as many times as possible. Then next variation is reverse plank. So you sit, your hands are out and you take your hip up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Relax and you can bring it down. But if you can hold it for 30 seconds, hold it for 30, a minute. But what is important is your hip should not go up, your hip should not be very down. Just average, right? And it should make a, can you just do it again? So you can make, see if there is a diagonal line which should be made. So we spoke about six variations of plank. Now there are many variations in these positions. So this is an isometric exercise where you are holding a pole. Now when you keep moving it, it becomes a dynamic plank. So for example, in a shoulder plank, we can touch our shoulder. So if there is a partner in front, we can actually clap with the partner. We can take one leg up. That's one leg plank. And we can even bend the knee. You just bend the knee. Try not to elevate your hip by bending the knee. Yes, that would be ideal. Now in the elbow plank, what you can do is, again there can be one leg plank. using your whole oblique muscles along with holding the plank position. And you can elevate one leg as well. Take one leg up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and bring it down. Similarly, you can take the other leg. Again, your hips should be not coming up when you're doing the workout. So the next plank can be variation of coming from shoulder plank to elbow plank or elbow plank to shoulder plank. Many ways of it. So you are in elbow plank, come to shoulder plank and back to elbow plank. It actually helps in strengthening your core, your upper body, and it's very good if you are not able to do push-ups. So it will strengthen your shoulder and prepare you to get into push-ups. Into side plank with one leg up, then side plank with knee bend and side plank with obliques. Now in reverse plank also, you can do lot of dynamic variations. So here you are using both the legs for support. You can actually elevate one of your legs. Yes. And hold it for as much time as possible. Also you can curl your triceps. Try to curl your triceps but without taking the hip all the way down and come up. Yes. So these are the few plank variations. But if you are uncomfortable, if you feel that you cannot go down, please don't try using plank. Though they say that plank is a very good workout, which I completely agree. There are many other workouts which are as equivalent to plank. Plus, if you are advised to not to go down, I have something else for you called vertical plank. Here if you notice, everything is in horizontal position. But in vertical plank, you can perform all these exercises in standing. We'll be talking about vertical plank in next video. Please do like our video, share and subscribe. Thank you so much.